welcome to Well Nutrition. My name is Michelle and I'm a holistic nutritionist. And so today I wanted to talk about a subject that is, you know, I'm really passionate about. I wanted to talk about preconception, nutrition, and health. And so I'm a new mom. My son is just a little over a year old, so I've sort of seen the journey of myself since before I was even pregnant and how it sort of impacted my body and health and my son's. So, I'm a nutrition nerd, of course, and I knew before I was having my son, I wanted to have the best health possible for me in my own body, because when you have a baby, everyone knows you are literally creating another human being, and all of that material is coming from the mom. It's coming from you, you know, all the basic building blocks of life, vitamins, minerals, you know, protein, everything is coming from you. And if your health is not at its most optimal, you can become really depleted and your health can really suffer. And you know, during your pregnancy, it's not going to feel the best. And even after, I mean, if you're breastfeeding and even just taking care of a little one, your health can really suffer. So I think it's so important before you maybe even think about having a baby to really focus on your own health and nutrition. And even if you don't want to have a baby, focus on your health and nutrition. It's obviously all we have at the end of the day is our health. And so we want to take really good, great care of it. So for me, I'm going to give you a few reasons why I think preconception nutrition is so important. First of all, the first one is that before you even have a baby, if you decide you want to become healthier, you start putting into place healthy habits, a healthy way of eating, and it becomes your norm, and it becomes very easy for you to eat healthy. It does, you don't even have to think about it. And you know, this may take you a year or a few months, or you know, it's going to take a little bit of time to sort of establish this healthy way of eating, but once it's already established, it's a no-brainer and you can just go on with your life. And this is so important because when you do become pregnant, like I did, I started, you know, the first few weeks of my pregnancy or sort of in the first trimester, I started having different cravings and I wanted to eat things that I hadn't wanted to eat in a really long time. But because I had healthy habits in place, I knew how to switch out unhealthy ingredients or not as healthy ingredients for more healthy ones. Not to say I didn't have a random pizza or random sandwich or bread or whatever. I normally don't eat those things in my day-to-day life, but I knew how to make it healthier or where to go to find a healthier alternative. So I had the taste that I craved. And I believe it's the taste and flavor you crave, and it sort of correlates with a memory of that food being a comfort food. And because the nutrition in those foods, your body's not craving white bread for the nutrition, it's craving it for the comfort. I really believe that, because there is no nutrition in white bread. And I mean, usually for women, they start eating these white bread and things like that because it sits in the stomach and it, you know, you don't want to throw up. But for me, when I would eat them, I would throw up. But if I ate the healthier alternative, I wouldn't. And I knew at least I was putting healthy, you know, nutrients into my body to help build my baby. So that's the first reason. I think having healthy habits so you can fall back on them when you sort of, your pregnancy takes you on this roller coaster ride of cravings, so you know substitutions that you can have. The second thing I think that's really great is that when you create healthy habits and you're eating well, I really believe you have an easier pregnancy. For me, I wasn't really uncomfortable until probably the last week or so of my pregnancy when I had my son in the middle of winter, so walking and things like that on icy sidewalks wasn't like the most comfortable, but I still, you know, I worked out literally until the day before I gave birth to my son, not really changing my routine. I didn't have any swelling. I still wore my rings. I was able to, I didn't have all of those sort of pregnancy aches and pains. I didn't have any back pain or anything like that. And I really believe it's that I was taking care of my body and really fortifying it. I also, you know, it goes along with healthy lifestyle choices, but you know, as we focus on nutrition, I knew that I was getting the best foods and I wasn't, you know, eating foods that would make me sort of have you know, the ill effects of pregnancy. I didn't really even have acid reflux or anything like that that I know plagues a lot of women, whether you're healthy or not, because your body is growing. So I really believe nutrition helped me to have an easier pregnancy. I didn't have to worry about gestational diabetes or any of these things, or toxicity. And you know, it's because my body was healthy and in a really good state before the pregnancy. The third thing that I think is really great when you sort of focus on preconception nutrition is that you have great, you know, postpartum weight loss. And that's not to say it for vanity's sake, just to get back into a healthier state for your body, for you to feel just more comfortable. I also believe that once you learn how to eat really well for your body and you create healthy habits, you're not in calorie counting mode or deprivation mode. And you know, I did a video last week on deprivation. Your body truly knows how much to eat. I didn't have to count calories. I was breastfeeding. I ate as much as I needed to eat. And because I was eating really nutrient dense foods, I didn't feel like I sort of crazily overindulged. Your appetite does obviously increase when you're breastfeeding. You're producing food for a baby, a growing baby. But I felt that it wasn't even a worry in my mind to lose weight after having my baby. I just continued on with my healthy habits and healthy routine, and it was just going, you know, my body was going to go where it needed to go when it needed to go there. And after about the first 3 months, I started to notice it shifting. And I mean, there's hormonal changes, but if you're eating really healthy, your hormones and all of that will be, you know, on your side. You're going to be doing, your body will know what to do and you'll have that confidence. The last reason that I think, last reason, there's so many reasons, but sort of like, you know, one of the last reasons I'm going to talk about that you want to have really great preconception nutrition is that you are going to give your baby an amazing gift. You're going to create healthy habits for them. You're gonna, while you're pregnant, be giving them, you know, eating the best food, so they're getting that in their amniotic fluid. And then postpartum, if you're breastfeeding and you continue to eat well, they're getting the taste of those foods in your breast milk. And then they're seeing you eat these foods. When they start eating solid foods, they'll want to eat these great foods. And I see this with my son. He is insane, I must say. Like, he eats everything I eat, and you know, he eats spirulina and broccoli, and it's not like I have to give it to him 20 times for him to want it. He'll literally just eat it the first go. And you know, we were at a restaurant and someone said, "We're really lucky to have a child like that." And I think I did the work leading up to that to give him that really great foundation, and I knew that. And it's not to say now, if you're a mom or you're pregnant or anything, it's never too late to start. You can always start giving your kids, you know, healthy foods and giving yourself healthy foods. I just think for me, you know, sometimes they say it takes 20 tries before a kid will eat, like, you know, a certain food. And for my son, everything I've given to him, he kind of really gravitates towards it. There's probably one or two random things, like cooked carrots, he doesn't really like, but raw carrots, sure, he'll like nibble on it. So just little changes like that, or little things like that I notice. But for me, it is ultimately, honestly, I love that my son has this foundation. It makes me feel so good, and I know it's just, I've given him this really amazing start to life. He doesn't even have to think about veggies like I did when I was a kid, and I hated them too. So you know, if that's any reason, I think it's to really give your kids the best start to life, and you can do it now. And hopefully, you know, if you resonate with this video and you're a healthy mom, and you have any extra tips, please be sure to leave them below and like this video, share it, comment. I love learning more things, or if you have any questions, I'd love to answer them and share some more information. So I look forward to talking to you soon. Thanks for listening, and hopefully you're on your way to having a really great preconception, you know, healthy body and nutrition and lifestyle. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Have a great day.